and scraping agencies, which were created by Act of Parliament without laws that established them. Legislators want the concept of merging government institutions to be guided by their performance in order to save those that are performing quite well. This comes after Parliament set up a 10-man ad hoc committee to study the ongoing merger. We have more.
Recently, 77 government agencies, commissions and authorities were approved for mergers, scrapping or transfer back to their mother ministries. With this move, the government hopes to save over 1 trillion shillings. The changes have caused panic among public servants and raised eyebrows among members of parliament who have cautioned government to go slow on the merger.
If taking them back to the mother ministries does not improve service delivery, does not take away the corruption there is, then we are wasting time. So as we do this, because we are saying, yes, the smaller the wage bill, the better. Okay? If the ministries would competently deal with this work and make sure they're delivering efficiently, there's value for money, there's no corruption, why not?
Now, for the issue of workers, the government has to look onto, if they're emerging, let them in subdivide in the sectors to see that some of these people are retained. Because all of them have a knowledge and idea about what they're doing, but I would request that they select the sectors such that they can be incorporated.
The people who will be laid off because of merging will further get jobs. Therefore, the government should consider these people who have been already working with the government, whoever is affected by merging, such that when they are advertising other jobs in the future, they consider them first.
Parliament is concerned that many agencies lined up for mergers were established by Acts of Parliament, and so government has to first consult Parliament extensively on the matter.
There is an ad hoc committee of the cabinet which was formed by the president to go and study the merger. I, of course, want to appreciate the efforts of the deputy speaker for forming this ad hoc committee, because some of these entities were formed with an act of parliament. Therefore, the executive cannot sit wherever it sits and decide on what was formed.
This ad hoc committee must actually carry a thorough study, entity by entity. And of course, some of these entities are by an act of parliament. So you cannot actually just merge them and disband without actually repealing the law. Where they are handling, say, properties, you should actually give them a liquidator to actually manage the assets and the liabilities, so that at least the government can form an informed decision. So this has not been done properly and in a manner which is actually agreeable. These are the issues which should actually be addressed.
Although many legislators agree with government on the need to cut public expenditure and enhance efficiency by merging agencies with the duplicate roles, they want performance evaluation to be done first to save agencies which have performed well. They mention agencies such as UNRA, Uganda Coffee Development Authority, and the Eco Opportunities Commission.
One of the critical action that the government has to take is to ensure that we even do an audit on how the government has performed on equal opportunity. And you know that we also subscribe to Strategic Development Plan, which is a global plan for the development of the country, of the world generally.
Absolutely, some agencies have performed to the expectations of Ugandans. For example, UCDA. Before UCDA was created, Uganda never used to export coffee. But according to the last budget that was read to Parliament, Uganda exported 2,526 bags of coffee.
This week, Deputy Speaker of Parliament Anita Among instituted a 10-man ad hoc committee chaired by Bukanga North County MP Nathan Byanyima to study the government concept of merging agencies, evaluate the justification of the merger, establish its cost benefit and its effects on employees.
The speaker has put in place that ad hoc committee. There is too many questions, yet too few answers. So government wakes up and says, we want to merge. Ideally, I mean, we are the ones who have been saying, the fewer the government entities, the smaller the wage bill, the better for our country and for the taxpayer at the end of the day. So it is good for the country, yeah? But we want to properly understand, one, the motive also.
They should come up with stakeholder analysis, engagement. They should come up with evaluation. They should come up with training. So that, because when I'm talking of efficiency, who are these people? Then they should actually come up with job evaluation. Because if you are saying there has been inefficiency, maybe there has been people, there's a possibility that some people have been putting on bigger shoes. Maybe there has been misappropriation of funds. So that at least you tailor it properly and a very smart arrangement.
Uganda Investment Authority, Enterprise Uganda Foundation Limited, Uganda Exports Promotion Board, Uganda Free Zones Authority, Private Sector Foundation of Uganda, and Privatization Unit are to be merged into one entity, among other changes. This report by Fred Kajubi for the news.